Okay.
Action.
Not action. So, me and Sean, we're going out to do a recovery. And we all, every time we go out to do a recovery, on the way out there, I always look at Sean and go, I've got a plan. And then I run my idea by him. And then he shakes his head and goes, all right, well, we'll figure it out. So, we're going out to do another recovery on Elephant Hill. Apparently, we've got a... It's going to be a disabled Jeep again. It may have rear-wheel drive, but the front tires apparently are missing. Or not connected. Not working either way. We're going in kind of not knowing... But, anyway, we've only got me and Sean. So, I want to get some more video of what we do. So, I'm going to try and carry the Jeep up by myself.
Because I'm camera guy.
And you camera everything. And so, we will have nobody in there running the brakes. If anything goes crazy. But it's a lot lighter Jeep than we're used to recovering. So I think we're going to be fine.
We haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, well, we're going in blind. But we're going to bring you guys along with us. All right, so we're back out at Needles. We're going to go into Elephant Hill and get another disabled Jeep. We just had to show up and talk with the park rangers. Like I said, we have to go the wrong way on the one way. So anybody that watches this, you're not allowed to go the wrong way on the one way. I get special permission and allowance to do this because we work with the parks. So don't just start going wherever because you see it on my videos. Please be respectful of the rules. Thank you.
Probably over a period of years as you evolved the whole thing.
Yeah, like I said, it's been in this current form for about four and a half years right now. I built the truck originally as a rock crawler for my buddy, and then I bought it back from him, and then it's slowly evolved into this.
Very good.
It was a necessity, and we just kind of started tweaking it.
Yeah, really good. All right, well, thank you.
Back on Elephant Hill, going down. So, I don't think our bowl's gonna fit under this rock.
What do you think?
Okay, well, pick it up and swing it over, and we're gonna pull the steering. Yeah, we'll pull the drag link and the tie rod and everything off, throw it on the truck, and then pick it up. But we gotta find somewhere to turn around is the biggest problem. We gotta pinch off the brake line, get brakes working back again on it, get the tire off, the steering off. Yeah. The plan is we're gonna pick it up so that we can get everything out from underneath it. Trying to talk loud so y'all can hear me, so you don't complain in the comments that I don't talk enough. Okay. Let me pull that off. And when we're towing this out, don't turn the steering wheel, because everyone's going to tell you that it doesn't do any good. Alrighty, so we got the brake line smashed flat and folded over and smashed some more. So Sean just topped the fluid off. We're gonna step on it and see what happens. Hang on. Alright, my glasses are on. Go ahead. Perfect. Yeah, we got nothing here. Sweet. So we've got brakes to get us out of here. Or to help get us out of here.
tight, but it like wiggles around, and I'm like, is that gonna fall off? Is that going somewhere? Guess not. Catch a lot of grief for my light bar. You know, I'm just trying to draw attention to myself or whatever. Yes, but not that way. A lot of these trails are very narrow, one way, all that stuff. So I like to have my light bar on to let people know that we're coming, we're hauling a vehicle, we're gonna take up a little more time, a little more space, just kind of give us room, that kind of thing. I'm not asking for special privileges or anything with the light bar on. I'm just making it aware that we're coming through hauling a rig. So that's why I do that.
It's running winch. I don't even want to mess with it. Before you go, there's that strap you parked right on it. There you go.
That'll work. I was even watching that spare tire. I'm glad it didn't fall off. Oh, yeah. Oh. That's a long pool. Thank you, tree.
So now we're back to the truck, so we got the Celebration Red Bull going. Everything went pretty smooth. Once again, thank you to Sean for tagging along on all my crazy stuff and being my super awesome helper when I'm, you know, driving one of these or whatever. But yeah, everything went really smooth. We tried to get some in-cab footage of the wrecker when we're making those tight turns. So I'm gonna try to do something with that. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thanks for watching.